Given the challenge in handling the number of witnesses, prosecution led by Joyce Tushabe asked to be guided on how to proceed. Accordingly, the matter was pushed to the next session.
By a court on its position, now that the session is ending, my lord, I don't know whether the court will be able to hear all the witnesses we intend to call within this session.
The trial judge, Alex Ajiji, decided to refer the hearing of this case to the next court session on grounds that the 3 days are not enough to hear all the state witnesses. Justice Ajiji, who chose to sit today on a public holiday, said the accused persons will be tried at the High Court in Kampala and they will be informed by the registrar on when the next convenient session will kick off. The judiciary has always organized several sessions, both criminal and civil in nature, as one of the strategies to reduce on the case backlog from the court system. But the defense lawyer Zephania Zimbe said his clients are suffering in jail. Zimbe says his clients have wounds inflicted on them by security operatives who arrested them. He added that they tried to ask for bail but nothing positive came out, and it is the reason why the accused persons want the case to be heard expeditiously. Abubakar Kawoo Yamulalo, the father of the late Chirumira, was not happy with the way the case was handled. He is struggling to look after the children left behind by his deceased son. Kawoya is also not happy with the government for refusing to pay gratuity for his son. The late Muhammad Chirumira was shot dead alongside a female friend, Reste Mbaba Zinalinya, near his home in Bulenga, Wakiso District on September 8, 2018. This is the second time the hearing of this case is being adjourned to the next convenient session. This means that the accused persons Karunji and Mwebe will go back to Chigo Prison, where they have been since October 2018, and February 2019, respectively.
Do you arrest your mission?